Hello and welcome back. It's January 2023 and getting close to the end of January. Wow, deep breath time. But for me, it's time to get real about the next phase of my empty nest downsizing journey, because as you probably know already, and I have certainly learned, this is not a once and done sort of thing. It's very much something that rolls on. You do the next loop and you go loop around again and you do it all over again, and each time different things go out, and it certainly makes you think about the things that you're bringing in. So number one step for me, and perhaps for some of you as well, is to redefine the goal. And the goal for me is not to live in a perfect minimalist, beautifully Instagram ready, curated home. I just want a comfortable and okay for me. It's that it may not be perfect, but it's done sort of attitude, and so it stays relatively clear and uncluttered and easy to look after, which is a huge, huge part of all of this. And it's the way I am happy with it. And for you, it will be something completely different, or it may be, or may not. You may like more, you may like less. That's the thing, you know, this is the mosaic of humanity. We do not all do the same things in the same way at the same time. So I want to encourage you all to just take it as it comes for you, so that when you start to relax a bit and you think, hey, I'm on the right path, that's where you should be. Each one of us will have a different time sort of commitment that we can spend doing this, and also probably a different level of need. You know, I want to get down to, you know, reasonably clutter-free and easy to live in. Now, because I moved 6 months ago, yes, it is already 6 months, then I know that I've already done that sort of quick cull that you do when you're moving. Well, or deeper cull you might have to do, but it's already been done. And so because of that, I'm pretty okay with what's here, what I want to keep, and all of that sort of thing. You know, the pots and pans are within reach of the stovetop, and the chopping board and all of those things. The day-to-day glassware and mugs for tea and coffee are all in a drawer right beside where the kettle is. All of the things that are organized. I don't have chipped plates and bowls. I don't have mismatched cutlery, that sort of thing. Does it mean it's perfectly organized? No, it doesn't. Things sort of went into general categories when I was moving, and I could probably do a bit more organization on a day-to-day basis. But I'm not too worried about them at that at the moment. I know of all the things that's a real mess, it's the plastic drawer, and with all of those, you know, I don't keep takeout containers, but any of my original sort of plastic storage things, they're all sort of a bit jammed in. And having said that though, I do use them in the refrigerator, obviously in the pantry when needed, so I do need to keep them, and they're not doing any harm. And the best way to be sustainable is to just use the things that you have, and if you've already bought it. So that's something I know I have to do. The pantry I've done, the refrigerator I've done. These are things that you just do on a day-to-day basis. That's that 10 minutes that you've got clear before you leave, and for work in the morning or whatever it is that you're doing, they just get done. And it's fine. And I sort of clean up as I go, empty the dishwasher, put everything away the same place, the same time. Everything's got a home pretty much in the kitchen. Just a couple of things need reassigning, I think is the word. So this is my list for my kitchen declutter. Ditch anything that's damaged or you have a duplicate of. For example, I had two cherry pitters, or olive pitters, that does for both, so one of them can go to my daughter-in-law. Anything that's chipped, any plates that are chipped, any mismatched cutlery, just, you know, however it's found its way in, God forbid, anything from takeaways, you know, those nasty chopsticks that you get with takeaways, those sorts of things, they need to go. They're not nice to use. The reason you didn't use them in the first place is that they're not great to use. I mean, if you have fabulous takeaway places that send you gorgeous ones, then fine, but my place doesn't. Any of those sorts of things, please, any of those nasty little soy packets or anything like that that you're not going to be using, make sure they're disposed of appropriately, you know, because you even see those little fish things that put soy sauce in. You see them everywhere and they turn up in all the plastic, so end of that one. So that's the sort of thing I get rid of. And then it's a matter of going through the pantry and the refrigerator for any food that is past its use-by date, any spices past their use-by date. Here in Australia, they go off really easily. The same for things like baking powder, because that really, I just note down when I opened it. Look, they're cheap. And you can use it for cleaning if it worries you that you don't want to throw it away. But you don't want to waste good ingredients by using old baking powder. And obviously spices, they just go lose their flavour. You might as well be putting sawdust in sometimes if they're not fresh and kept and well sealed. What else? Pantry, yes, anything that you know has just been there for too long. Make sure things like coconut doesn't go rancid. It can check that your oils are all in good condition, do a bit of a clean up, and once again go through the refrigerator doing pretty much the same thing, especially with sauces and any sort of dressings, those sorts of things. It's always good to keep an eye on it because they can go off and nobody wants that. Then it's a matter of organizing your pots and pans to be together and stacked so that the ones that you use most frequently are on the top and at the front, anything used less so at the back and underneath. And that's pretty simple, isn't it? Same with bakeware. The things that you're using for cooking, just stack them so that they work. Things like casserole dishes, all of those sorts of things. The most favoured can be in the top, you know, the drawer that's the easiest to reach or the cupboard that's the easiest to reach, keep them at the front. Don't put anything on top of them if possible. But if you are truly, truly time poor and you just need something to cheer you up a bit because you want to feel like you're getting something done, then the obvious place to start is doing a quick sweep of the countertops. Your worktops, make sure that they are as empty as possible, as is sensible for the way that you cook, the way that you work in your kitchen. Just do it and make sure they're clean. Do a good clean, put anything away that needs to be put away, that has a home. Think about where something could live if it doesn't have a home. But if you use it on a daily, pretty much daily basis, and you're just always reaching for it, then, you know, corral your work utensils into a container or sometime, you know, a jug or a canister, something that will keep them all together. Clean your chopping boards, oil them if you have, you know, if that's what you use, if you're using wooden ones, which I recommend. What else? You know, clean the coffee machine, make sure everything's tidy, and wipe down the worktop, and that's pretty much going to give you an immediate feeling that you're in control, and sometimes that's the win we need. What else? The other thing to do if you have those sort of 15 minute blocks is to just look at one drawer or even one side of one drawer. I mean, if it's a true junk drawer, it might need, you know, 20 minutes, but if it's just a normal cutlery drawer and you can take them out unit by unit, wipe down that area, pop them straight back again, that's going to be a good enough moment, and you're going to have everything straight and organized and ready to go. Anything like that that you can get is a quick win. Maybe it's one shelf of the pantry cupboard, maybe it's half a shelf, maybe it's just quickly going through the refrigerator and checking to see what's in there for dinner tonight, or that needs to perhaps go out into the green waste. We have a good green waste composting system now, which I love, because it means that I don't have to feel so bad about those last sort of slightly ratty bits of something that is not at its best and I don't really, you know, want to use, and it's not soup season. Though to be fair, I do tend to freeze a lot of things ready for sort of the offcuts and things like that, you know, from doing vegetables. I do save those up for soup season. I just pop them in a Ziploc bag and put them in the freezer. And even if you only have 5 minutes at the end of filling up the dishwasher or doing that quick, you know, hand wash in the sink, if you've got a clean cloth in your hands, open up your refrigerator and wipe some of those shelves. It gives you an immediate feeling that, oh, it's okay, my life is not out of control. Those little wins, I'm 100% for. So that's my little start to the year. I know I'm not going to beat myself up about this. I'm just going to do them when I can, when I've got a moment, and I'll get back into the habit of making videos because I miss you, because I really like to say hi, and I love the connection. So I hope that wherever you are, that you're happy and healthy and well, and whatever you're doing, I hope that you're having a wonderful day and a fabulous week and a great start to 2023. Honestly, who thought it, hey? Take care, lots of love, see you in the next one, bye.